Hey guys, today I'm going to the. Hey guys, today I'm going to do the most requested video, my handbag collection video. This has been requested by you guys from so many years, and I never did this one because I'm already a little concerned about sharing the collection videos. I have noticed that when I do collection videos on my channel, some of you totally love it and some of you don't like it. So I just want to give a quick disclaimer. All these handbags are bought by me with my own hard-earned money. Nobody gives me. And I totally love to invest in something which I will cherish lifelong. Everything that I show in here is everything which I have bought in a couple of years. Not I have bought it together, and I have invested a lot of money in this. And when I buy handbags, I just don't go and buy it randomly. I do a lot of research on internet before I go and pick it up from the store, and mostly I prefer to buy handbags only at the store when I see them personally, not online. So if you like these kind of videos, I'm sure you're gonna enjoy this. And if you are someone who don't like to watch these videos, you can go ahead and check my other videos. This is not at all a show off video. This is something which I have invested my money on. They are all very close to my heart. So if you like this video, then keep on watching. The first handbag that I want to share with you is my Michael Michael Kors Jet Set Traveler Tote MacBook handbag, which is in black color. I chose this one because it's a universal fantastic handbag which is made up of Saffiano leather. It has this gold hardware which is removable or detachable. I can take it off completely. It is an open tote handbag where I can put in my keys, my laptop, my iPad, and it is having a thin strap shoulder, very easy for traveling purposes. And this is one of my recent purchases in my handbag collection. In my recent Hong Kong haul, I bought this from the Hong Kong airport, the duty-free shopping stuff, and I totally love it. Another handbag which I again bought from Hong Kong airport is from duty-free shopping is the Michael Kors large Fulton crossbody bag. This is the handbag which I'm currently using a lot. I just carried it yesterday because it has a back pocket and it has a lot of zip in the front, which I totally love about it. It has a Michael Kors standard logo and this beautiful brown leather. This is something which I know will be using a lot every day. When I buy handbags in Singapore, I usually go to Luxury City boutique, which is a 6,000 square feet huge boutique in Singapore, where you get a lot of designer handbags at a discounted price, because in Singapore everything is triple the cost of actual price which you get in USA. So when I buy handbags in Singapore, I usually prefer to get something which is on discounted price, so that even after discount it is something which is close to the US price. So let me share what I bought here. Now, next handbag is a Coach handbag, which is one of my favorite colors. So girlish, so summery or spring color. This one is called Peyton Bennett Mini Satchel Persimmon handbag. It is made up of Saffiano leather. It has a gold hardware. It can be used as a crossbody as well as a arm handbag. This one has a fabric lining, it has a top zip, and it has a double handle, and this is a very light handbag for everyday use. I totally prefer to use this as a work bag as well as a shopping bag as well. The next handbag is a limited edition handbag from Coach. It is called Legacy Willis crossbody purse or handbag. It is a bright coral color. I like it has this hook to open the back, and as well as it has a Coach trademark over there. It has the silver hardware. It is a very cute handbag because if I want, I can remove this cross body strap and use it as an arm bag very easily. This is one of the cutest bag. I totally respect my decision of buying this one because it is so pretty. It looks like a huge handbag come into small size. This is a messenger and crossbody bag both. It is made up of leather. It has some tassel as well as Coach hardware and Coach leather print on this. And this is something which I use a lot. The next handbag is the one which you have seen in my airport travel video. When I went to India, I carried this handbag. This is a Guess tassel It's a black studded pink tassel gas handbag, and what I like about this handbag is that it is very huge in size. It has a good leather, covers up a golden hardware zip. It is also can be used as a shoulder bag or as a crossbody bag, and it is very spacious to travel. The next handbag is a small handbag which can be used as a shoulder bag, especially for dinners, or you can also just use it as a clutch. It is from the Guess Nixon collection. It is sling purse where you can use you can save a lot of coins, or you can use it as a coin purse as well. And I like the leather and the Guess logo, everything about this bag. These are the handbags which I carry, especially when I don't want to carry a lot of stuff with me. The next is again similar to the previous handbag. It is a Guess Nixon sling clutch wristlet, and this is the one which I usually keep inside the big studded bag so that I can put a lot of stuff like my purse, like my money and as well as my mobile in this. It is a leather beige handbag, and it can be used as a wristlet as well as a handbag at both. The next handbag is again from Guess. This one is from their Noelia collection. It is a multicolor coral beige leather handbag, but it is not some leather. I don't know which kind of leather this is exactly, but it has this Guess logo on this, and this is something which I also carry to the beach because I feel this is something which is kind of waterproof material. I carried this to Hong Kong during the travel because it is a medium sized bag. I didn't want to carry something which is very huge or something which is small. It is good enough to carry a medium sized stuff, and trust me guys, it's been 1 month since I'm back from Hong Kong and I still have my travel tickets and everything lying in there. I still have to clean this bag and keep it back, but this is one of the colors which I really like. The next handbag is something which I have used a lot. When I came to Singapore with my first salary, this is the first handbag which I bought in Sing dollars. It's from Charles & Keith. It's a black medium sized shoulder and crossbody bag. It has tassels and a gold hardware, a top zip and a lot of space. And this handbag is a little bit dirty right now because I've used it in all seasons. I've used it in rain, in sunny weather, and it has been just in my dust bag. So I need to dry clean this very soon. But this is one handbag which I totally like. I also like this this hardware at the bottom to give the hold of this handbag. It can be very easily carried on the arm. This is not leather, it is like PU leather, and it has some material like velvet kind of stuff in this, but this is one of my favorite work handbag as well. This next handbag is one of the huge handbags I have. I've shared this in my what's in my airplane handbag video. This one I purposely use for the travel because it carries a lot of stuff, and again it is not weighed at the airport. It is made up of leather. It is a beige color handbag. It has two zippers on the top, very easily carry a lot of stuff. It also has a crossbody strap, and it is from Charles & Keith. One thing which is a disadvantage you can say about this handbag is that the leather of this handbag is quite heavy, so if you stuff in a lot of stuff in this huge handbag, sometimes it does get a little bit heavy to use, but still one of my favorites for the travel purposes. The next pouch, you can say, not exactly a handbag, but if you want to carry it as a wristlet or a arm clutch, you can go ahead and carry that. This is from Kate Spade. This is called Little Chillon Cosmetic Pouch or Purse. I use it to carry a lot of makeup in this, but not only makeup, I sometimes just put in my mobile phone and cash and carry it around like a clutch bag. And I like about the little bow Kate Spade logo in this. I totally like that bow in the Kate Spade logo about the Kate Spade handbags. But like the Kate Spade handbag, I also have a Too Faced Cosmetics little frill pouch which I got with a kit that I bought from the Sephora Singapore, and I use it as a makeup pouch again in my handbag so that my makeup doesn't spill in my handbags and I can carry everything very easily. And this is very girlish and cute with frill and pinks all that around. The next handbag is actually a bag which is actually called a wash bag from a brand called High Design. It's a genuine leather brown wash bag. It carries a lot of stuff. I have been using it from past 4 years, especially for travel purposes, and to store all the toiletries for me and my husband both. And it is a little bit heavy and it does get a lot of heavier when you put in your stuff, but it is something which keeps everything very secure in this. I totally love this handbag from High Design. The next handbag that I have is a crossbody black studded string bag from the brand called Nine Best. I bought it in USA from Newport Mall 4 years ago, and I have been using it a lot from past 4 years in all the seasons, and this has come so far. I think I got it from the Nine West store itself, and this was my one of the first purchases in USA, and I'm totally in love with this handbag. And this handbag is leather. It is called Drawstring Crossbody Bag from Nine West. The next handbag that I own is one of my favorite work bag. It is a leather bag which has some studs and silver hardware. I bought it from Shoppers Stop India. It is Elizabeth Arden black leather bag. It is very comfortable, very easy shoulder bag, and I have carried this a lot. I used it in India as well in Singapore as a work bag, and I totally admire this one. The next handbag is my Guess Chelsea clutch bag. It is a huge clutch with a wristlet. It is a brown leather handbag. Totally love it. It has the studded work on it, and this is something which I totally say that is not comfortable at all. I like it, so I bought it, but I haven't used it much because it's not easy to carry a lot of stuff and hold it all the time. So this is one of the bags which I just bought it for the color and the design. The next handbag that I have is a floral print fine grain leather handbag from an Indian brand called Vaccaro India. They are a Bangalore based leather company, and I totally like the design and the hand painted material of this handbag. The leather is so soft and lightweight. It is a genuine leather, and it has some hand painted floral designs all over this handbag. This is something which I totally like, but I haven't used it much because I'm really worried if the painting of this leather handbag gets faded with time. Let's see what happens. But the design and the quality and the latest floral patterns on this handbag is something which made me to buy this handbag. This next handbag is from India. As you see, this kind of handbags are called jhola bags. This is actually from a designer called Krishna Mehta, and it is from a brand or a website called India Circus. So this is an India Circus Krishna Mehta designer Cripping Bird handbag, because you can see it has some floral and bird prints on this, and it is something similar to the rust color. I use this specially to carry the dress materials, not as a handbag, not actually as a bag, as a classy bag, but I do carry it as a stuff material. Like yesterday I went out to give my Indian dresses for stitching, so I carry a lot of dresses in this. So this is something which you can use it as a regular wet market bag or something which you want, I don't know what. But I usually use it to carry my dress materials or something which I don't want to throw in some plastic bags. Instead of plastic bags, you can use it as a reusable bag. And I totally like the material and lightweight of this bag. The next handbag that I have is this Alpha Makeup bag. It's an Alpha Vanity bag which I got on my wedding time. I know nowadays nobody, I think, uses the vanity bags as a makeup bag, and nobody carries it because all the airline rules and everything has been changed recently. But this bag is something very good if someone who is getting married, and if you want something to carry your makeup during travel, this is one of the bags. It is very lightweight, hard material, and it has this kind of clutch. So this is one handbag you can very easily carry and carry a lot of makeup in this. So let's go and move to the cheaper handbags that I have. This is one of the most inexpensive handbags which I bought from Singapore. This is, I think, the first handbag in Singapore which I bought from a flea market. And this was just a $10 crossbody bag, mint color. It has a lot of space inside this, and the hardware and everything is so perfect. I have been using it a lot in everyday life, and this is still doing good. A little bit dirt here and there because of the regular use, but this is something which is very nice and trendy. Okay, you guys know that how much I love Kyo in Singapore because I get the shoe of my size over there and I definitely buy a lot of fancy clutches. So this is one black clutch which I already showed in my haul video sometime back because I bought a matching high heel shoes with this. It's a very nice rhinestone clutch, a lot of space. It has a sling as well. So I use it specially for Friday night parties or just for a regular traditional wear. Another handbag is also from Kyo Singapore. It's a nice crystal work beige handbag which is actually a clutch as a party wear material, and it also has a sling if you want to use it as a sling bag. This is something which also I have with my matching shoes and I totally love this one as a party wear or a festive wear clutch. This is another clutch which I bought from Kyo Singapore. It is gold work. It has rhinestones, crystals. I especially bought it for the wedding in my family when I was going to India last year. And this is something which is very classy. You can just wear it for all the Indian weddings. Actually for all the weddings, whether it's an Indian or Christian wedding. And it is something which is very classy and I like to carry this one very much. It is like one of my favorite clutches to use all the time. This is just a cute rubber pouch. If you have seen, these kind of material are very much in market. I usually keep my coins in this or some chewing gums or the toffees in this. And this one is something which can use as a coin purse in all your purses. So it's easy to throw it in all the bags and easy to carry. I got it from a store in Hong Kong. This next handbag is from Hong Kong. It is a floral print handbag. These kind of floral print handbags are out in Guess. I've seen Lino Paris in India selling this. And these are kind of handbags which are very trendy right now. But I got it from a store in Hong Kong and I totally like it. I have also featured it in one of my Hong Kong videos. I totally love the material, the color and the prints of this handbag. This next handbag is from a website called baginc.com and they have sent me this handbag. This is a Kara leather tote handbag from baginc. It is very nice. I think this was something $100 on their website when I bought it. And I like the gold hardware, the top zip completely closed from all the side. Very nice deep down tote bag. I used it as a replacement for diaper bag a lot of times because sometimes when I don't want to carry a huge diaper bag, especially when my baby grew to 9 months onwards, I started using this handbag as a replacement for diaper bag to carry all thermos, water, milk, everything. And it does carry a lot of stuff. This is definitely one of my most worn and most used handbag for regular use. And I am just going to show you all these four handbags together. This is a leather, brown or maroon clutch, and these pink, red and black handbags are the four street fashion handbags. No high brands. You can find them online in a lot of websites. These are just the fashionable trendy designs and I just have featured them in some of my videos, so you guys know that. Nothing fancy, just everyday kind of handbags that I also have in my handbag collection. Okay, these are another pouches. These are packet of four pouches which I got from Hong Kong. They are pink floral print Anna Sui bags which I use specially to carry my makeup, keys and just as a travel bags. I just want to let you know there are a couple of handbags which are back in India which are not with me right now here because when I go to India I keep one bag there and bring another back Singapore, so I don't have that right now here, those handbags here, but I am either planning to ship them here or just go and get them here. So once I get them here I may do my updated handbag collection video for you guys. I just came back from grocery shopping and I just realized that I forgot to share my Kara leather wallet which is a passport holder with you guys. I have shared this in my what's in my bag video a couple of years ago if you check my channel. So this is a leather passport holder plus wallet which I use from past 4 years regularly and it is always in my bag. The leather is a genuine leather and it's a black bag. I have two of these, one is brown and the black one is the one which I use the most. So this is another hand wallet which I use most of the times and it's in my purse. And before you guys go ahead and ask me how do I save my handbags, I keep all my handbags clean in their respective dust bags. So I have a lot of dust bags. I never forget to take the dust bags from the store when I buy the handbags. And the small bags I still keep in the small boxes. But for the huge handbags, I throw away the boxes and keep them in the dust bag with the silicone bags that they come with. So I hope you guys enjoyed this my handbag collection video. I'm so tired after filming this. I need to wrap up all this. Thank you so much for requesting to do this video, because I now realize I have a lot of handbags and I should not buy any more handbags. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in some other video. Bye. I love you all.